The Aubrey Valley near Seligman, Arizona. It was one of the nation's most successful reintroduction sites for endangered black-footed ferrets until the ferrets disappeared. Exactly what happened remains a mystery, and the Arizona Game and Fish Department continues looking for clues as it tries to reestablish ferret populations in Aubrey Valley and the nearby Double O Ranch. September 8, 2025, a Game and Fish Department airplane touches down at the Seligman Airport. On board are 11 endangered ferrets from the National Black-Footed Ferret Conservation Center in Fort Collins, Colorado. Members of the Game and Fish Department's Black-Footed Ferret Project head out onto the tarmac to greet their special guests. The captive-born ferrets spent the last month or more in preconditioning pens, learning how to survive in the wild by preying on prairie dogs and living in their burrows.
So our ferrets got to fly first class. So we met them at the airport, loaded them all up in vehicles, and we brought them into the office. So they are set, they get to settle down for a little bit after their flight and be ready for tonight for their big day.
Tonight, they'll be released into the wild. It's an important step made possible by months of hard work by Game and Fish biologists and summer interns.
We couldn't do a quarter of the stuff we do without volunteers and interns.
They hike for miles looking for prairie dogs and counting burrows.
We go out and we do transecting for prairie dog colonies. We'll go out there and we'll count every single burrow that's on the landscape within the site. And then we'll say whether they're active or inactive for prairie dogs.
They use that information to estimate the size and map the densities of Gunnison's prairie dog colonies.
So we're in a study right now designed by USGS and Fish and Wildlife to determine if we have plague out there. So we are testing different methods of flea control.
Prairie dogs are highly susceptible to sylvatic plague, which is transmitted by infected fleas.
So some sites were treated last year, some 2 years ago.
They've been treating prairie dog colonies with a flea control called fipronil. The only way to know if it's working is to do some trapping.
So we are trapping prairie dogs for 5 weeks straight.
So we're just looking to get as many prairie dogs off of each site to get an idea of what's going on disease-wise and flea-wise. The idea with plague and prairie dogs has always been that if plague comes through a colony, all the prairie dogs will die.
So for us, that's the frustrating part, is we're not getting that or seeing that. But we are getting prairie dogs that test positive for plague, so we know it's on the landscape. We just don't know how bad, and it's not bad enough to wipe out the entire colony.
They're just not seeing the mass die-offs they'd expect.
Some have tested positive before, we've recaptured them, and now they're negative. Some have been positive, and then they stayed positive. Some were, it's all over the place, so we're still getting more questions than answers.
In 1996, Game and Fish started reintroducing endangered black-footed ferrets in the Aubrey Valley. The population peaked in 2012 when the department confirmed at least 123 ferrets were living in the wild.
Every year thereafter, our population would basically half itself.
And by 2019, the population estimate was zero. In 2024, they released 10 ferrets across Aubrey Valley and the Double O Ranch, but never saw any of them again.
That's the hard part. The ones we released, we didn't find. So it's like, where did they go?
Is it disease? Have they dispersed across the landscape? Are we just not seeing them as frequently? Is our survey methods maybe just not as effective?
Or maybe they're being eaten by predators or succumbing to the effects of drought.
Something we're not even considering. I don't know. I mean, most likely it's probably plague.
My boy Nico here, he's gonna distract the prairie dog.
So that's what Ceci's doing right now. She's keeping it distracted. I'm gonna go in, open the trap.
Processing prairie dogs is one way to get a better understanding of what's happening on the landscape.
Just like that, we got one.
So we are knocking the prairie dog out with isoflurane. This just makes it easier to handle them because they will do everything in their power to bite you.
He already looks a little sleepy. He's closing his eyes.
So the first thing that gets done after they're knocked out is to weigh them.
540 grams.
Then they get combed for fleas.
And I'm just gonna be brushing up against the fur.
With the ISO, it does knock the fleas out and they drop into the water.
This site has been relatively flea-free, so we haven't gotten a lot of them.
And cut just that quick.
And we clip a toenail to get blood for our Nabuto strips, and that's what we turn in to test for plague.
These ear tags also keep track of which prairie dog is which. And now we're measuring the hind foot.
Everything we do is to help the ferrets. Prairie dogs are their main diet, and so because it's their main diet is why we study the prairie dogs and work to actively protect them.
So all the prairie dogs that we had processed over the summer collecting the blood from them, we sent it off for testing, and there came back with a really high percent positive for plague rate in Aubrey Valley. Some of the sites we had planned to release at were as high as 40 and 60%. It wasn't a good location to be releasing them anymore.
Meanwhile, the average rate of plague on the 00 Ranch was right around 3%.
Let's do it.
So all the ferrets tonight will be going out on the 00 Ranch.
The ferrets are vaccinated for plague, and the release sites have been treated with flea control, which studies are showing remains effective for about a year.
It's sad when we don't have them out there, so it's great to be able to release them now, just kind of get them out there. Give them a chance to get settled before the winter hits, and then hopefully we'll see them again in spring.
Trail cameras show how long the ferrets remain at their release burrows, but only time will tell what comes next.
Moving forward, I just hope we're able to release ferrets and have them survive and can get a handle on what's going on out there and treat enough areas that we have ferret survival.